What's up, guys, and welcome back to my Master Machine Hunting series for Horizon Zero Dawn. With Forbidden West coming out in just a few weeks, I know there's lots of people playing Horizon for the first time, or maybe you're replaying the game to get hyped for the sequel. Either way, in this series, we're covering the most effective ways to take down each machine. So even if you played before, stick around because I bet you'll learn something new. That's especially relevant for this video because I know Shellwalkers can be tricky even for experienced Horizon players. Now, unlike basically every other machine hunting guide out there, instead of showing you super overpowered strats that rely on the best gear in the game, I'm going to show you how to take down each machine using gear and abilities that make sense for the level you'd be when you first encounter that machine. I mean, let's face it, seeing those speed takedowns of huge machines is cool and all, but it really isn't helpful for most people, and especially not for new players. So whether you're a veteran Horizon player diving back in to prepare for Forbidden West, or you're brand new to the game and just trying to figure out how to take down these crazy machines, welcome, this is the series for you. In this video, we're going to learn how to take down Shellwalkers with just a single weapon and ammo type. And no, I know what some of you are thinking, it's not a Blastling or a Tripcaster. Now, Shellwalkers are difficult for a few reasons. First off, they're relatively strong, but you can run into them pretty early in the game while exploring the Nora lands. At first, they might look like adorable hermit crab robots, but you pretty quickly find out that they're actually really challenging. Shellwalkers are different from pretty much every machine in the game. First off, they have an energy shield that makes it very difficult to hit them. You'll also typically find them in groups of 3 or 4, plus there's usually other machines around as well. On top of all that, they have a bunch of really strong melee and shock attacks. Also, unlike most other machines, they don't have an obvious weakness to fire or freeze, so at first glance it seems like Shellwalkers are just super tanks that you should avoid until you get better gear. But they do have a significant weakness that will let you take them down even early in the game. And by the way, those crates on their backs have some great loot in them, and Shellwalkers themselves can drop purple mods, so it's definitely worth learning how to fight Shellwalkers early. So, as you should do with every new machine, when you run into a Shellwalker for the first time, make sure you scan it with your focus right away. This will add it to the machine catalog, where we can review information about it and come up with a strategy to take it down. Usually, I like to look for a general body weakness, but the Shellwalker doesn't have one. Instead, it has two components weak to tear, the lightning gun and the shield claw, and two that are weak to all types of damage, the crate holders and the power generator. So this is the main reason Shellwalkers are tricky. Their weakness is tear, but the game never really explains how to use tear. Basically, tear is a specific type of damage that will blast components off a machine. Certain components, like the ones highlighted in the machine catalog, will deal a chunk of damage to the machine when they're torn off. The way tear works is much less obvious than other ammo types, so people tend to underutilize it. For example, most people don't know that you can shoot tear blast arrows at the ground to knock down human enemies. Now, tear damage is mainly dealt with tear blast arrows, and these are the key to taking down Shellwalkers. So taking another look at the machine catalog, notice that the power generator located on the Shellwalker's belly is responsible for all of its shock-based attacks. It also deals a ton of damage once it's destroyed, so we definitely want to focus on this component. The other components we want to disable right away are the lightning gun and the shield claw. The Shellwalker uses these for shock and melee attacks, so tearing them off will disable those attacks and deal a good chunk of damage at the same time. Finally, remember to knock off the cargo container before completely destroying the Shellwalker. If the cargo container is still on there when you destroy the Shellwalker, the container gets destroyed too, and you lose all the extra loot inside. So here's our strategy. Hit the lightning gun, shield claw, and power generator with some tear blast arrows right away to disable those components and deal some big damage. With an early game bow, it's going to take at least 2 or 3 tear blast arrows to destroy them all, but remember, you don't actually have to be super accurate with the tear blast arrows. As long as you get them to stick to the Shellwalker somewhere near those components, it will deal tear damage to all of them. In fact, for the power generator, it can be easier to shoot tear blast arrows at the ground just in front of the Shellwalker, so it walks over the explosion. The blast will still do tear damage to the power generator. With the lightning gun and shield claw, it's pretty easy to see once you've knocked them off. For the power generator, you'll know you've knocked it off when you see a shock explosion that stuns the Shellwalker. When this happens, you can take the opportunity to deal some free damage with arrows or use the critical hit skill if you have it, but I would actually recommend using this time to switch your attention to other Shellwalkers. Now here's the secret. Once you've torn off all three of those components, the Shellwalkers can't damage you at all. Go ahead and test it. Sure, they'll keep walking up to you, but they can't actually deal any damage. Tearing off those three components makes Shellwalkers completely harmless. At this point, go ahead and knock off any remaining cargo containers and finish them off however you'd like. I'd recommend just meleeing them with your spear to conserve resources, but you can shoot them in the eyes with regular arrows too. Alright, Let's see this in action. Alright guys, so I'm going to actually show you two examples of fighting shell walkers in two different locations. The first one is what I think is the easiest location because only one shell walker spawns here. So this is just outside Mother's Crown. And I'll quickly go over the gear we're going to use. So for an outfit, I'm going to use the Nora Survivor Light. This is a good early game outfit you can get pretty cheaply, and it has some elemental shock resistance, which is good because the shell walkers have a lot of shock-based attacks. If you do have a shock mod or a melee resist mod, I would stick that on here, but I'm not going to put anything on there for now. Alternatively, you could use the Nora Protector Medium. That's another good early game outfit that's pretty cheap. This one's focused on melee resist by default, but if you have a shock mod, that would be a great one to stick on here. Or an additional melee resist if you have it. But we're going to use the Nora Survivor Light. As for a weapon, our main one is going to be the Karza Sharpshot Bow, which lets us use these Tear Blast arrows, the purple ones here. That's the arrow type that's going to let us deal the tear damage that we need pretty badly for shell walkers. And I am going to put one handling mod on here. Let's see exactly what this is. So this is a 29% handling mod, and basically that just means it's going to be able to draw and load a little bit faster. I think it's reasonable to expect at this point in the game you'd either have a similar handling mod like this, or you'd have like two green ones that would add up to roughly 29% or something like that. So I think that's pretty fair. It's tempting to put tear mods on a bow that can shoot tear blast arrows, but it's actually kind of counterintuitive because adding tear mods does not increase the effectiveness of tear blast arrows specifically. So if you want more of an explanation on that, I'll leave a link to a Reddit post that explains it really well in the description, but handling mods are really what you want to put on a sharp shot bow for the tear blast arrows, okay? As for skills, the only one I'm going to use is Hunter Reflexes, which is my favorite one that lets you get a slow-mo effect when you jump, which just makes it easier to aim. That's going to be really handy for the shell walkers. If you have critical hit unlocked, that's really useful when they're stunned to do a lot of like melee damage to them, but it's not totally necessary for this strategy. The only one that I think you really need is Hunter Reflexes. But if you have critical hit or some other things unlocked, they may come in handy. And then last thing I'll just show you real quick is difficulty level. As with every video in the series, I'm on very hard. So if you're on a little bit easier difficulty, this will just be easier for you. Okay, so this is our site, which is one shell walker. I'm gonna go ahead and scan it so we can highlight its weak components, and I'll equip my tear blast arrows here, and we just want to hit it right in one of the claws to start off.
That'll help.
You can see it knocked off both of them, and now I'm gonna try and hit on the ground right in front of the shell walker. There we go. So we hit the power generator off the bottom. Now you could hit it right now with a critical hit if you have that. But typically you're going to have other shell walkers around at this point, so you'd want to switch to like fighting them while this one's stunned for a while. And you guys are going to be able to see now that he has all of his components disabled, he actually can't do anything to us. He'll kind of huff and puff and go around like he's going to do something, but he actually can't do anything. So we can just kind of take him down with our spear. I'll do a heavy hit just to get him down pretty quick. And a critical hit to finish him off. You can just keep whacking him. You can also take some regular arrows and hit him in the eyes, but that's pretty difficult because they're a pretty small target. That being said, that is a pretty good tactic. Like if you disable a whole bunch of shell walkers, if you want to practice your aim, you can practice hitting them in the eyes while they're harmless.
Oh my, now.
Okay. So that's the first one, and then we'll go to a site that has like three or four of them. All right, so we're here at the second site. This is a more typical site. I'll kind of just show you where we are real quick. More to the northeast here in this wooded area. I say it's a typical, more typical site because there's three, maybe there's a fourth one hiding around here somewhere, but this is how you're typically going to find shell walkers in groups of three or four like this. And this time I will put on a shock resist potion before we get started. And anytime you get a free shot like this at their crate holders, I just take those right away so we can make sure we have the crates taken off. And then we'll put one underneath this guy. That stunned him, so we get a free shot at his power generator, which is nice. Same thing with this guy. Oh, we'll actually have to run around the other side. Put one under him again. That's what the shock resist potion's for. That shock blast radius is pretty big. Don't have to be perfectly accurate again. See, that one actually took off his claw and shield generator, even though I didn't hit them directly. Just try and get this guy's power generator disabled. There we go. And while he's stunned, I'll run around and hit his crate off. And doesn't look like we have a fourth one. So I think we've taken care of them all. You can see at this point they're harmless. They'll kind of come up to us and act like they're going to attack, but they can't actually do anything. So you can just go around and smack them with your spear. That's what I would recommend. If you want to, you can take out some regular arrows and hit them in the eyes. But you can see they're pretty hard to hit, and they don't do a whole lot of damage with an early game bow like this. So I actually think you're going to waste a bunch of resources trying to do that. I would just go ahead and maybe use some heavy hits like that if you can stun them, and then if you have the critical hit, you can take them down like that. Or if you don't have either of those, you can just go ahead and smack them till they're down. There we go. Took care of them all pretty quickly. That shock resist potion definitely helped prevent us from taking a whole bunch of damage when the power generators explode. So I think that's really important if you're earlier in the game and have a lot fewer hit points. Okay? As you guys can see, Terror Blast arrows are really effective against Shellwalkers. This strategy does take some practice, but I promise if you try it a few times, you'll be taking down Shellwalkers like a pro in no time. Now the downside to this strategy is Terror Blast arrows do cost a lot of resources to craft. Specifically, you'll burn through Echo Shells pretty quickly. However, I think the extra loot you get from the Shellwalker cargo containers more than makes up for this, and it's still less resource intensive than using traps or tripcaster blast wires. That being said, if you really are struggling with Shellwalkers, go ahead and set up some blast wires to bait them into. You'll use more resources, but it'll help deal some extra damage. Taking a shock resist potion before diving into the fight can help a bit too. And if you want to farm up some Echo Shells, Longlegs are a great way to do that. I'll leave a link in the video description for my video on how to take down Longlegs. Alright guys, that's my Master Machine Hunting Guide for Shellwalkers. We covered a super effective strategy for taking them down fast, and I hope it helped you out. If it did, leave me a comment letting me know, and if you're still having trouble with them, let me know about that too, and I'll try and respond and help you out. For all the Horizon veterans out there, I'd be curious to hear about your favorite ways to take down Shellwalkers, so go ahead and leave me a comment about that too. Horizon is my personal favorite game of all time, and my goal with this series is to make the guides I wish I had when I first started playing. If you enjoyed this video, or if you learned something, hitting that like button would be much appreciated. We're going to cover all the difficult machines in this series, and I'm super excited to do the same for all the new machines in Forbidden West when it comes out. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss the rest of the series. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.